people are under a winter storm warning and in the path of Octavia, a storm with double trouble tonight. We have ice coating trees and roads like in this video in Middle Tennessee.
Then Octavia's snowy side, breaking records here in Bowling Green, Kentucky. The first 8-inch snowstorm there since 1968.
And take a look at the radar. You can clearly see where the dividing line is between the snow, the ice, the rain. We've got ice falling in upstate South Carolina, northeast Georgia, eastern Tennessee, western North Carolina, even back into parts of central Tennessee. Snow in places like Charleston, West Virginia, eastern Kentucky, through most of the state of Virginia, and back into North Carolina. And hey, we're with you tonight to keep you informed and prepared for the storm. I'm Alex Olson.
And I'm Dave Schwartz. Good to have you along. Well, we have live coverage of Octavia tonight, but first, let's get you updated on the very latest news headlines coming out of this storm.
36 million people are under winter storm warnings right now, and another 73 million will be affected by some form of winter weather in the next 24 hours. Not a great day at the airports. Nearly 2,000 flights were canceled within the United States today. And a new message from the National Weather Service in Raleigh. They're warning of significant accumulation of sleet and ice across a large swath of central North Carolina.
Now, our nation's capital is bracing for Octavia. The snow has begun. They could pick up 8 inches of snow before it's all over tomorrow morning. Virginia's governor declared a state of emergency, and winter storm warnings are in effect till Tuesday.
Meteorologist Kate Parker is live in D.C. tonight, where Octavia is making its entrance, Kate.
Yes, you know, Octavia has already dumped some snow here, even though it only started snowing about 2 hours ago. But here's the deal. We had snow on the ground from Neptune. It was quick, a little bit of snow, but I want to show you what is going on here on the sidewalks. Now, we do have a little bit of ice. You know, we've got the ice on pre-treated surfaces, the roads, the sidewalks. But here's the deal. This ice doesn't work once you get below a certain temperature, or the salt doesn't work. It doesn't prevent things from icing over and becoming slick. The roads are really cold. By really cold, I mean the air temperature here has been well below 20 degrees for all but a handful of hours since Saturday night, which means that those surfaces are going to ice over incredibly quickly. The snow just started falling, and you can see that it has accumulated, not just on grass, but on things that you're driving on. So you can see it's actually already a little bit slick, even though the snow just started. Thankfully, it's President's Day here, so we don't have a whole lot of people out on the roads. We don't have a lot of foot traffic. Now, the metro has not shut down in this area yet. They have suspended some disability services. That's the really only issue we've had. But again, the snow only started here 2 hours ago. It's going to peak overnight. So if you live in or around the district, there's no driving tonight. It just can't happen. You know, these cars already, we know that you're used to driving on at least a little bit of snow, but once we start accumulating here, these surfaces, you know, they're pretty slick. This snow is going pretty quick. Fortunately, it is a dry snow. It's a fluffy one, so you're not going to see this really wet snow, but you are going to see a higher accumulation because of that. The cold air means that our ratio is going to be closer to 15 inches of snow for every 1 inch of liquid precipitation. Dave and Alex, the normal is about 10 to 1, so we could see those accumulations. I think we're definitely going to get over that 6-inch mark here. There's the White House. Isn't it pretty? It's pretty, but no going out on the roads.
Absolutely.
That'll be one of the few buildings in Washington that will look pretty much the same tomorrow as it does today.
Camouflaged, right? And we want to send it out to our lab where storm specialist Carl Parker from the D.C. area, familiar with the area, is going to walk us through what we can expect with the remainder of Octavia.
Yeah, we're going to get pretty healthy dumping there, as Kate mentioned, but we're really concerned about the ice storm that's going to take place in North Carolina tonight, as we could be talking about a half of an inch, maybe 3/4 of an inch of ice accumulation, and that is really a crippling ice storm. That's when you start talking about widespread power outages. And that will be the worry right in the central part of North Carolina between Raleigh and Fayetteville. And let's begin with how this is happening. So you've got the cold air coming down from the northeast here into the Tennessee Valley and also into the Carolinas. Then we've got warmer air that's moving up from the southwest that is overriding that cold air. That's how we get rain falling into the sub-freezing air and then freezing on the way down or on contact. Now, in addition to that, you've got this stronger mid-level wind in white right in here that's going to begin to move into North and South Carolina very late tonight and early tomorrow morning. And along with that, we're going to get more lift in the atmosphere. So that's going to step up the precipitation rates. Now, what we're looking at here is a model depiction of the surface freezing line. Really important. That's the dividing line between rain and freezing rain. And then you've got the freezing line aloft at about 5,000 feet. So we know that between those two, you've got a warmer flow that's coming up and over top of that sub-freezing air at the surface. So in the pink here, that's where we are getting the freezing rain. This is 1 o'clock in the morning. I want you to watch how long this goes on. This lingers right through the overnight with heavier rainfall rates. That's why we're talking about potentially half of an inch of ice accumulation. Could be a lot right near Greenville. We're getting freezing rain there right now. Charlotte also a concern, but look at that right in there, central North Carolina. That's where we're talking about a half of an inch or more. That is a really big deal, and that could mean that your power is out and maybe for a while. There's a look at the forecast in Raleigh, and there is the prime time there developing late tonight and going into early tomorrow morning. And right now, we are seeing moderate freezing rain in eastern Kentucky right around Knoxville and Oak Ridge. Also now getting moderate freezing rain in Gainesville. Looks like we're going to be okay for the most part in Atlanta, with the exception of the far northern and eastern suburbs and exurbs. Right now, temperatures just over the freezing mark in the Atlanta metro, and not expected to fall very much. And then farther to the north and east, it is light snow now. Western North Carolina, that's going to change over, and more moderate snow in southwestern Virginia, and light snow has made its way into D.C. So this is what we're thinking in terms of snow totals. Pretty big area of 5 to 8 from southern Virginia across the Delmarva. Within that, it's going to be 8 to 12 in southeast Virginia and down into Salisbury, Maryland, Ocean City, Maryland. 5 to 8 is what we're thinking in D.C. A little north of that towards Baltimore, not as much. And then not a lot of snow here across southeastern New England, but some, and that's going to be primarily during the afternoon tomorrow. Back to you, Dave. Alex.
Thank you, Carl. And you at home, you're also helping us show the impacts of Winter Storm Octavia.
Yeah, here's a sample of the video you've already sent in. The snow has been falling in Hartford, Kentucky, nearly 10 inches reported there already. We'll be back with more.
Let me talk to you about retirement.
401k is the most sound way to go. Let's talk asset allocation.
Sure.
You seem knowledgeable, professional.
I'm actually a DJ.
No way.
That really is you.
If they're not a CFP pro, you just don't know. CFP, work with the highest standard.
Started my Camry. Remembered the choices I'd made. To be bold where others are scared. To show her right from wrong. And realized my little girl had become an amazing human being. Who will make choices of her own. Toyota. Let's go places.
At Intel, they have technology that lets your face be your password. Oh, that is one secure password.
Intel. This is where it all changes.
Hey, have you guys heard about probiotics?
For digestive health?
Yes, and did you know that Truebiotics is a daily probiotic that helps in two ways? It supports digestive and immune health by working in your gut, where 70% of your immune system lives. Try Truebiotics today.
When you're hungry for the craveable taste of tender fish and shrimp, nothing's better than Long John Silver's. Now, for a limited time, enjoy our new crispy golden fish and shrimp basket for just $3.99 at Long John Silver's.
Shopping online is as easy as it gets. Wouldn't it be great if hiring plumbers, carpenters, and even piano tuners were just as simple? Thanks to Angie's List, now it is. Start shopping online from a list of top-rated providers.
Visit AngiesList.com today.
But I'm telling you, the winds have really picked up and through here. And there's another one! That's number... You gotta be kidding me! Wow! You can have your $500 million jackpot in Powerball or whatever the heck it was, but I'll take this, baby!
Currently in our area, 72 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Tonight, some clouds. Low 63. Winds south at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Tuesday, sunshine along with some cloudy intervals. High 86. Winds southwest at 15 to 25 miles per hour. Tuesday night, showers later at night. Thunder possible. Low 64. Chance of rain 50%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Winter Storm Octavia.
Full force right now with still several more hours to go.
Live coverage from across the region continues in a moment, only on the Weather Channel.
Apples are good. A Strongbow hard cider, better. But Strongbow over ice is the best. Enjoying Strongbow over ice with your slow motion horse, the bestest. Strongbow, world's number one hard cider.
Well, sir, after some serious consideration, I'd like to put in my 15-year notice.
You're quitting?
Technically retiring, sir. With a little help from my State Farm agent, I plan to retire in 15 years.
Wow, you're totally blindsiding me here. Who's going to manage your accounts? This is a devastating blow I was not prepared for.
Well, I'm going to finish packing my things. 15 years will really sneak up on you.
Jennifer will do your exit interview, and Adam made you a cake.
Red velvet.
Oh, thank you.
I made this.
Take charge of your retirement. Talk to a State Farm agent today.
Did you know? Fresh Step Extreme Lightweight Litter isn't just light. It's also the best lightweight for eliminating odors. Amazing, right? For superior odor elimination, try Fresh Step Extreme. Lightweight.
When you're hungry for the craveable taste of tender fish and shrimp, nothing's better than Long John Silver's. Now, for a limited time, enjoy our new crispy golden fish and shrimp basket for just $3.99 at Long John Silver's.
Here is a live look at a Virginia traffic camera. This is in the southwest part of the state, and we did not slow it down. This is how slow the traffic is really crawling along. Interstate 81 southwest of Roanoke. It's near the town of Elliston. Traffic on the right is moving to the east. And you can see not a ton of moving going on. There was a minor crash, according to Virginia DOT, east of here, and that is causing major delays, that accident near the town of Glenvar. So if you're familiar with the area, you know it starts to get a little hilly, curvy in
yeah,
the road.
Right, and the problem is it's going to get dark soon, mm-hmm. and the snow will continue, so there'll be more on the road.
Absolutely.
Poor visibility. Got to be careful. Mm-hmm. Well, in Arkansas, road crews are working around the clock until the sleet and snow there is cleared.
And the ice isn't just creating problems for drivers. Ice on power lines knocked out power to more than 30,000 customers. The Weather Channel's Ron Blome is in Little Rock with a look at what people are dealing with tonight.
Well, good afternoon. One of the things we're seeing in Little Rock is that the freezing rain and the sleet that fell on top of it about an inch is now turning into ice. This is the driveway coming out of our hotel where there's been a little bit of traffic in and out today. And look at this. This is just a sheet of ice. It's bumpy, but there's not much friction here or traction area for cars to move around in. The city of Little Rock is really not prepared for this. I mean, the modus operandi here is going to be wait for it to melt off. It's going to be up to 39 degrees tomorrow, maybe approaching 40 on Wednesday. So it means that for the city of Little Rock, it's going to take a little while to get traffic moving. And in fact, that's the story statewide. If you go across the center of Arkansas, there was snow in the northern tier, heavy rain in the south, but across the center, we had 1 to 3 inches of sleet. I walked down to the interstate not too long ago, and it's the same situation. It is the sleet that is packed down. I talked to the highway department. They said traffic is moving across the state and they expect it to continue to move slowly. Their goal is to try to get one lane down to pavement in each direction. But the story for the Mid-South, Arkansas, running over to Tennessee and west to Oklahoma is to go slow travel with all of these conditions. That's the story in Little Rock. Back to you.
Thanks, Ron. That's always the best way to handle it, is just go slowly, if you have to go at all. You know, we picked up all this snow. See the snow icons up here near the Arkansas-Missouri border? And then sleet, that's that stuff that bounces. And then the freezing rain. That's what this little icon is, those little icicles. That's the water from the sky that freezes on contact with bridges and overpasses, such as, and railings. And that kind of thing. Be careful. Right now in Nashville, they're reporting IP plus. That's heavy sleet. And further southeast, with slightly warmer air, we've had some major icing around Murfreesboro and all across southern and eastern Tennessee. Got to be careful. Atlanta, Georgia now, 32 degrees at Dobbins Air Force Base, northwest side, and at DeKalb Peachtree out there in Chamblee. So once the sun goes down there, bridges and overpasses could be icy. Be careful. Certainly northeast Georgia will be no picnic to drive tonight. Knoxville, Tennessee, freezing rain near the 32-degree mark, ending as some light snow early in the morning, sunshine in the afternoon. Here in Charlotte, we're expecting an ice storm. We've got sleet right now. Greensboro and Raleigh, snow with a changeover to freezing rain later tonight. So we'll have some ice in Charlotte. That's going to be a problem certainly in the morning as the temperature drifts down into the 20s. And then all this mess moves out of North Carolina further north, Norfolk, with some ice possible. This would be crippling ice. This would be power outage type ice. Raleigh, Durham, almost down to Fayetteville, and then west to Charlotte. So this is going to be an area where you want to be prepared for a power outage tonight. It's cold. Temperatures are in the teens and 20s, so make sure you're warm enough. Stay warm, stay dry. Here's Alex.
And again, you guys at home are helping us show the impacts of Winter Storm Octavia. Here's a sample of some video you sent in. Everything from roads to trees, even trucks coated in ice in Tennessee. Metro Nashville now under an ice storm warning. We'll have more after the break.
How do I get hotel deals nobody else gets? I know a guy.
Priceline Negotiator.
I know this guy. Codorito.
And this guy, who knows a guy?
Hey, guy.
I know a guy in New York, Vegas, Dallas. I've known some guys for decades, and some, nice to meet you. Let's deal. My competitors may know a guy, but I know over 60,000 guys.
And girls.
Exclusive hotel deals up to 60% off. Priceline.com.
When you're hungry for the craveable taste of tender fish and shrimp, nothing's better than Long John Silver's. Now, for a limited time, enjoy our new crispy golden fish and shrimp basket for just $3.99 at Long John Silver's.
For great rides. Geico Motorcycle. See how much you could save.
Zantac heartburn alert. Stop. Nexium can take 24 hours to work. Zantac's different. Zantac rushes relief in as little as 30 minutes. For relief without the wait, try Zantac. No pill relieves heartburn faster.
Earning unlimited cash back on purchases, that's a win. But imagine earning it twice. Introducing the Citi Double Cash Card. It lets you earn cash back twice. Once when you buy, and again as you pay. It's cash back, then cash back again. And that's a cash back win-win. The Citi Double Cash Card. The only card that lets you earn cash back twice on every purchase. With 1% when you buy and 1% as you pay. With two ways to earn, it makes a lot of other cards seem one-sided.
But I'm telling you, the winds have really picked up in through here. And there's another one! That's number... You gotta be kidding me! Wow!
We all want that little black dress moment, that look good, feel good moment. But when you're overweight, it's more like little black dress. I don't even want to get dressed. I'm tired. My knees hurt. I'm not going up those stairs again moment. You know what I'm saying? I'm Marie, and I lost 50 pounds on Nutrisystem.
Now you can lose weight fast with Nutrisystem's Fast 5 Plus. Lose 5 pounds in your first week, plus 1 inch off your waist, or your money back guaranteed.
You'll get perfectly portioned meals that are ready in minutes. So there's no counting, no measuring, no guesswork. Simple.
Order your 28-day Nutrisystem plan right now, including Fast 5 Plus. Get 1 week of specially selected meals. Plus, you'll get 1 week of energizing shakes free and 1 week of Craving Crusher shakes free.
This is your moment. Don't wait. Start looking and feeling great today.
Call now, 855-807-THIN, and lose your first 5 pounds fast.
Experience and commitment to go the distance with you.
Call now to request your free decision guide. This March.
One man's trash.
This is perfect.
Is another man's wood-powered Jeep gasifier.
Brainstormers, premiering Sunday, March 22nd, only on the Weather Channel.
Currently in our area, 71 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Tonight, some clouds, low 63, winds south at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Tuesday, a few passing clouds, otherwise generally sunny. High 86. Winds southwest at 15 to 25 miles per hour. Tuesday night, showers later at night. Thunder possible. Low 64. Chance of rain 50%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Well, here's a look at Norfolk, Virginia. We've got some light snow falling. Temperatures in the teens. Snow falling on the south side and also up there in the peninsula. That'll change over to some freezing rain and sleet later on tonight.
Yeah, and this traffic is headed towards the Portsmouth Tunnel, so you can see things are really slowed for that drive home.
And speaking of you, the viewer, here's a look at radar across Virginia. And you can see that's all snow at the present time, with a line of some heavier snow up toward Newport News heading to Williamsburg. So we've got wintry weather. Welcome to Boston, yeah. I think we should say, huh? We've had so little snow here.
Right. Well, hey, our Bonnie Schneider has been monitoring social media all day as winter storm Octavia impacts you at home. Bonnie, what have you seen out there?
Oh, so many people have been sending great pictures, Alex and Dave. In fact, I reached out to people via my social media pages to find out how winter storm Octavia is impacting them and their families. Let's go ahead and take a look at some of those images now. The first picture comes to us from near Nashville, Tennessee. Robin White posting this incredible picture of ice covering tree branches and berries. Now, she tells me that her concern is that the tree branches could actually, some of them have fallen in the area, and she's under an advisory certainly for power outages. And Nashville is going to see ice certainly with this event. Now, here's what the storm looked like through areas of Roanoke, Virginia. Rob Roberts took this photo at the downtown area. He says this was at Interstate 581. This was earlier today and already snow-covered roadways. Ashley Taylor has been tweeting lots of pictures, and this is one she sent to me, really a nice close-up in northern Georgia, so you can see the ice-covered leaves of some of the trees in her area. She told me that she is planning to just hunker down and stay home because there's already plenty of ice in North Georgia, and where she's located, that's in the northeastern part of the state. And finally, let's head over to Russell County, Kentucky. Now, that's in the southern portion of the state. Wendy Sullivan Walls shared this picture with me on Facebook, and she says that the sky is gray because the snow was falling at such a fast rate. And she says where they are south of Louisville, they've had already several inches of snow, but they've actually had about 7, and the snow is still falling. She describes traffic is moving very slow and local authorities asking people to stay home, and that's exactly what she's doing. Well, feel free to reach out to me on Facebook or tweet me at Bonnie Weather, and we'll make sure that your pictures get on the air. Alex?
Awesome. Thank you so much, Bonnie. We want to talk about the cold as well. It's relentless this week, and it's sticking around. Look at the record lows that were set this morning across the Northeast. Each one of those black dots, that is a record low that was set all the way from northern West Virginia, Morgantown at -5 to Alpena, Michigan at -27, -18, Erie, -36 in Watertown, -1 in Reading, Pennsylvania. Temperatures right now, single digits, at least on the plus side of zero for Detroit, for Buffalo, for Burlington and Binghamton, 18 in Boston, 20 in New York, 17 in Washington, D.C. When we factor in the winds, though, it still feels like it's below zero in places like Pittsburgh and Detroit and Binghamton, Burlington. Your feels like temperatures around -6, feels like 4 in the city of Boston. Tuesday morning lows, again, sub-zero in Albany and Burlington and in Buffalo, 10 degrees. will be your low in Pittsburgh, 16 for New York City, upper teens in Washington, D.C. By Wednesday morning, still in the single digits for places like Buffalo and Albany, minus one in Burlington, 16 in the Big Apple. And on Thursday morning, we're still in the single digits and teens in most spots, seven for D.C., zero in Pittsburgh, minus four in Buffalo. Some of the notables. Nashville, your average low is 32. Look at your low on Thursday morning, minus nine. What the heck, Dave?
That's impressive, Alex. You know, millions of people are in the path of winter storm Octavia. We'll take you hour by hour to show you what to expect up next. Octavia already brought heavy snow across the state of Kentucky. This is in Alverton. They received 4 inches and could see eight by tonight.
It's easy to buy insurance and forget about it. But the more you learn about your coverage, the more gaps you might find.
Like how you thought you were covered for this.
Check it out, Mom.
When you're really only covered for this. Or how you figured you're covered for this when you're actually paying for this.
Danger. Warning.
You might be surprised at what's hiding in your coverage. Talk to Farmers and get smarter about your insurance.
Danger.
We are Farmers. Bum, 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 bum.
Brought to you by Farmers. Get smarter about your insurance at farmers.com.
There's confidence. Then there's trusting your vehicle maintenance to Ford Service confidence. Our expertise, technology, and high-quality parts mean your peace of mind. Now you can get the works. A multi-point inspection with a synthetic blend oil change, tire rotation, brake inspection, and more. $29.95 or less.
You know, there's a more enjoyable way to get your fiber. Try Philips Fiber Good Gummies. They're delicious and a good source of fiber to help support regularity.
Mm. These are good.
The tasty side of fiber from Philips.
Looks like 20 feet.
At Intel, they have this technology. You can take a picture and measure the distance before you jump.
Intel, this is where it all changes. Fiber One now makes cookies. Find them in the cookie aisle.
When you're hungry for the craveable taste of tender fish and shrimp, nothing's better than Long John Silver's. Now, for a limited time, enjoy our new crispy golden fish and shrimp basket for just $3.99 at Long John Silver's.
This Valentine's Day weekend, you can really experience eHarmony for free. It's the first step in finding that perfect person for you. Connect for free this Thursday through Monday only.
According to the U.S. Department of Energy, most homes have air leaks and drafts that waste so much energy, it's like leaving a window open in your home all year long. Don't let another year go by. Call Champion Windows at 844-4-CHAMPION. And right now, when you buy two rooms of windows, you get the third room free. Plus, Champion now offers no money down, no payments, and no interest for 12 months. So call 844-4-CHAMPION today. Because every home needs a champion.
I went to Ancestry.com, but I thought, I'm not going to make it very far. I knew my parents and my grandparents. And then it happened. I got a leaf. When I clicked on it, I could actually see my grandfather's draft card from World War I and his U.S. Census from 1910 and another member's tree that had my great-grandparents and their parents and everything. And it all started with my first leaf.
Who will you discover at Ancestry.com?
But I'm telling you, the winds have really picked up and through here. And there's another one! That's number... You got to be kidding me! You can have your $500 million jackpot in Powerball or whatever the heck it was, but I'll take this, baby.
Currently in our area, 71 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Tonight, some clouds. low 63. Winds south at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Tuesday, a few passing clouds, otherwise generally sunny. High 86. Winds southwest at 15 to 25 miles per hour. Tuesday night, showers later at night. Thunder possible. Low 64. Chance of rain 50%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Winter Storm Octavia.
Full force right now with still several more hours to go.
Live coverage from across the region continues in a moment, only on the Weather Channel.
We are back with a live look over Washington, D.C., the Capitol building, and the snow falling. You can see the White House.
The White House
blending
up to its name, right? The walls are white, and soon the roof will be white. Perhaps that's starting already, huh?
Absolutely. And so far today, ice has caused the most problems, though. It will continue to do so as Octavia spreads into the mid-Atlantic. But we are here. We want to keep you informed and prepared. I'm Alex Wilson.
And I'm Dave Schwartz. Most people I talk to say ice is the worst to drive on. So far, Arkansas and Tennessee have been hit by the worst by this ice storm. Take a look at some video. This is from Nashville, Tennessee.
Now, ooh, that's tough.
That's ice. That is rain that fell and froze on the window. That's exactly what freezing rain is. It looks like rain, it sounds like rain, but the surface it hits is below freezing.
And I'm hopeful that Katie was just taking this video to show us what it looks like, because you definitely would never want to drive if that's on your windshield. You can assume that's on roads, especially bridges and overpasses, and be careful when you step out on your front porch or your back porch, because it could get real slick real fast.
Then, of course, with the weight of the ice, down come the tree limbs and the power lines. Arkansas, 32,000 without power. Mississippi, 3,500 without power. Tennessee, 4,600. North Carolina, over 1,000.
So Mississippi, Tennessee, North Carolina all have problems, but by far the biggest issues with the power outages are in the state of Arkansas. I want to take a look at the top snow totals so far from Winter Storm Octavia. Looking at Richmond, Kentucky, at just over a foot. Down into West Virginia, they've seen a little over a foot of snow. Cape Girardeau, at a foot, and a foot for Sacramento, Illinois as well.
So what Boston's been getting for about 4 weeks, you got here. Yeah. So this is a little bit what that's like. Now, more than 100 plows are out treating roads in the Washington, D.C. area where the snow has just begun.
And meteorologist Kate Parker is live in the nation's capital tonight. And Kate, what are people there saying? You know, they haven't had many snow events, many winter events this season.
No, not a whole lot, but they had a little bit of snow with Neptune. Sir, can you, I'm going to hop in with you for a second. What are you doing here?
Just monitoring the conditions to see if we need to start treating the roads.
Treating the roads? Or are the sidewalks don't look too bad. Obviously, I saw some salt on them earlier, and that's doing its job. But have the roads been pre-treated?
Yes, they have been pre-treated.
Do you think, what kind of snowfall does it take to really shut down things here around the Capitol?
A good inch or two.
Well, we're getting that pretty quick. This only started 2 hours ago. Will you guys monitor through the night?
Yes, we will. All through the night.
All through the night. Well, thank you so much. You guys are doing an awesome job. We know you're staying on top of it. Good luck, because the snow is going to increase and it's going to keep on coming down, folks. You can see how it's already started to accumulate on some of these sidewalks. Now, these were pre-treated with salt. The roads also, I was driving around earlier today and they had a briny mixture all over them. You could see the salt residue. But I want to show you that we're already getting it accumulating on these surfaces, not just the grass where the temperature's lower. You know, you're on roads here where it's already getting slick, and you can see there are people out and about. So I want to give you the good news, and I want to give you the bad news. The good news is, it's a holiday. You know, it's President's Day. We don't have a tremendous amount of people out and about and around the Capitol. So there's your good news. The bad news is the fact that we go back to work, back to school tomorrow here and around D.C., and people are going to be waking up to a bit of a surprise. These snow totals are going to go up overnight. I think we could get an inch per hour rate as we go through the overnight. And this is a very dry snow, so it's very cold outside. Our ratios are going to be higher. We could see 15 inches of snow per inch of liquid precipitation ratio. To give you an idea, on average, you would get about a 10-inch per 10-to-1 ratio. But I think maybe in spots, Dave and Alex, that we could see a greater than 15-inch. I mean, I don't think it's out of a question that spots across Virginia and a little farther north that we could see a 20-to-1 inch ratio. 20, how about that?
Right, but we're not going to get 15 or 20 inches. Right? That's just the ratio.
No. To be clear, we won't get that.
Right.
Yes, that's just the ratio.
Thank you, Kate, from Washington, D.C.
But and now we head out to our lab with storm specialist Carl Parker. And Carl, you know, a lot of Virginia and parts of the Mid-Atlantic have been looking up north saying, hey, can we get in on some of this? And it looks like this one might get them a snow day.
Yes, it will. And I love the way that D.C. Public Works guy said that a good inch or two is enough to shut down the city. I could tell you that from being there in D.C. for many years that can be true. We've gotten a lot of really big snowstorms up there, but this year it hasn't been that way so far. Here is a look at what we're expecting in the D.C. metro. And 6 inches is what we're thinking near downtown, a little bit more as you get farther south, more down into southern Maryland and into southeastern parts of Virginia, maybe 7 inches around Fredericksburg. And then we're thinking a bit less as you move even farther north, more like 5 inches in Baltimore and 4 inches in Columbia. Obviously, this can change. This is just sort of ballparking it. But generally, we think less on the north side of the Baltimore, Washington metro and more on the south side. And it's all going to be happening, as Kate mentioned, overnight tonight. We'll wind down tomorrow morning just in time for that rush hour. And you can bet it's going to be a tough one there all along the Beltway and 270 and 66. So here's a look at the larger picture in terms of snowfall. And the heaviest of snow is likely to be centered on southeastern Virginia and southern parts of Maryland right around the mouth of the Chesapeake Bay. And then to the north of that, just a bit of snow coming up into New England. Here's the model forecast. I want you to pay attention to that that pinkish area right there. That is where we've got the freezing rain and a very significant ice storm most likely there in North Carolina. Then it's snow to the north, D.C., Maryland, Virginia, and the snow going on in the afternoon, New York and also in New England. But we don't think it's going to be a real big deal. Certainly not going to help after all you've been through. But at this point, it looks like it's going to be mostly lighter amounts. So there's a light snow that is coming to D.C. right now. It's a little more moderate in southwestern Virginia around Roanoke and Blacksburg. It is snow now in North Carolina. But this is what is coming your way. That is freezing rain showing up there in eastern Tennessee, moderate freezing rain in Knoxville, also northeastern parts of Georgia around Gainesville. Really, really close call for the Atlanta metro as the colder air has been trying to press a little farther to the south and to the west. But at the same time, we've got some heavier rain coming in. And along with that heavier rain, there is warmer air aloft. And I think it's going to bring some of that warmth down and probably be able to fend off that cold that's trying to come in through the back door there in the northeastern part of the state. So I think for the most part, we're going to be okay for Atlanta. And let's take a look. We've got a live picture now of the Atlanta metro. So again, it's going to be the north and eastern parts of the metro. Talking about Gainesville and Athens, certainly going up along 85. That's where we're going to see some issues. But as far as right downtown, I think for the most part, we're going to be okay. There's a live look. Obviously, a lot of wet weather and a lot more on the way here. And I want to quickly tell you also about what's going to happen with tonight in North Carolina. And there you've got the cold air coming down into North and South Carolina. You've got warmer air aloft coming over top of that. And we will also see some fairly heavy rainfall rates, which will mean potentially a half of an inch of ice accumulation there in central parts of North Carolina. That's a really big deal. When you get above a quarter of an inch, you start talking about really serious traffic problems, and then you're talking about weighing down those branches and power lines. So this could be a crippling storm in a part of central North Carolina in particular, and we could be talking about widespread power outages as a result. That's primarily going to take place overnight tonight. Dave, Alex, back to you.
All right, thank you so much, Carl. And coming up, we are going to track Winter Storm Octavia as it heads into the Northeast.
Yeah, New York City, Boston, Philly. We're expecting 3 to 5 inches of snow right here in Philadelphia. Find out when it all clears out. That's coming up next on Weather Center Live. We're glad to have you. Up next, your local on the 8s.
Currently in our area, 70 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Tonight, some clouds, low 63, winds south at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Tuesday, a few passing clouds, otherwise generally sunny. High 86, winds southwest at 15 to 25 miles per hour. Tuesday night, showers later at night. Thunder possible, low 64. Chance of rain, 50%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Life isn't measured in how many days we have, but what we do with them. This year, you could do what you've always done. Or you could awaken your senses and connect with the world as it was meant to be. That voice inside you, that's Alaska calling. Because vacations, like days, are measured by what we do with them. And here, the days last forever. Begin your adventure at AlaskaBeyondYourDreams.com.
Apples are good. A Strongbow hard cider, better. But Strongbow over ice is the best. Enjoying Strongbow over ice with your slow motion horse, the bestest. Strongbow, world's number one hard cider.
I have the worst cold with this runny nose. I better take something.
DayQuil cold and flu doesn't treat your runny nose.
Seriously?
Alka-Seltzer Plus cold and cough fights your worst cold symptoms plus your runny nose.
Well, what a relief it is.
Let me talk to you about retirement.
A 401k is the most sound way to go. Let's talk asset allocation.
Sure.
You seem knowledgeable, professional.
I'm actually a DJ.
No way.
That really is you.
If they're not a CFP pro, you just don't know. CFP, work with the highest standard.
Next.
Expected wait time, 55 minutes. Your call is important to us. Thank you for your patience.
In the nation, we know how it feels when you aren't treated like a priority. We do things differently.
We'll take care of it.
We put members first.
Thank you.
Join the nation.
Nationwide is on your side.
At the end of the day, my hands are beat up.
Especially during the winter times, hands are splitting, cracking, making it very difficult to do my job.
O'Keefe's Working Hands. Guaranteed relief for dry hands that crack and split.
Best stuff we've ever used.
It just works.
Learn more at workinghands.com.
So you think all auto glass companies are the same? Well, they're not. When your windshield needs to be replaced, nobody makes it as worry-free as SafeLite. First, SafeLite emails a photo of the technician, so you know who to expect and how soon.
Right on time.
SafeLite's one-of-a-kind TrueSeal technology places a new glass in perfect position for a strong, reliable bond you can trust.
Wow, that looks great.
You're all set?
Thank you so much.
Schedule now to get the SafeLite advantage.
SafeLite repair, SafeLite replace.
When you're hungry for the craveable taste of tender fish and shrimp, nothing's better than Long John Silver's. Now, for a limited time, enjoy our new crispy golden fish and shrimp basket for just $3.99 at Long John Silver's.
Shopping online is as easy as it gets. Wouldn't it be great if hiring plumbers, carpenters, and even piano tuners were just as simple? Thanks to Angie's List, now it is. We've made hiring anyone from a handyman to a dog walker as simple as a few clicks. Buy their services directly at AngiesList.com. No more calling around, no more hassles. And you don't even have to be a member to start shopping today.
Angie's List is revolutionizing local service again. Visit AngiesList.com today.
What should I do with my money? Whether you're a multi-million dollar investor or just starting out, the answer is Betterment. Betterment is the smarter way to invest and is the largest automated investing service in the U.S. If you're building wealth or preparing for retirement, we provide a personalized recommended asset allocation and your money is put to work in a globally diversified portfolio. Experience smarter investing and secure your financial future. Betterment. Investing made better.
Snow is falling in Washington, D.C. Fortunately, it's a holiday, a federal holiday, so there's not a lot of traffic, and that's a good idea
on
a night like this.
That is good news, isn't it, on a day like today? So you might notice it appears there's less cars than usual. Yeah, that is for a reason, because obviously many of the employees are federal employees, and they don't have to go to work today.
And they're fed up.
They are.
Yeah, they're fed.
Absolutely.
Right.
Hey, and our Bonnie Schneider, she's been scouring social media all day long because, well, you've been home, you've been tweeting or sending in Winter Storm Octavia's impacts from viewers to us.
That's right, Dave and Alex. And some people are just like hunkering down, you know, waiting for the worst of the storm. So I've been speaking directly with several people as Octavia is bringing snow, wind, sleet, and rain and ice to their homes. Joining me on the phone right now is Carrie Childers. She is in Nashville, Tennessee. And Carrie, we spoke earlier. I know you and your husband have a baby daughter and you have special concerns about this storm.
Yeah, I do. A lot of major businesses are closed today. A lot of tree limbs are down in the neighborhoods as well as trees.
And what is your concern about that as a mom?
It prohibits me from taking my daughter outside and enjoying the snow.
Yeah, I'm sure it does. And I know that you went to the grocery store and you had quite an adventure there. Was that last night?
I sure did. 6 o'clock last night, I got one of the last four loaves of bread.
Oh, well, that's a triumph in itself. But as you go through the evening hours, I know that you're concerned because the temperatures are so cold. And of course, there is the risk for power outages. So besides that loaf of bread, what other supplies have you kept on hand just in case you lose power?
Definitely diapers for my daughter, milk, you know, food for dinner and all. As much as I can get my hands on, the shelves were pretty bare.
Yeah, it sounds like it. So what is your plan going forward with this storm? Are you planning to stay in tonight and tomorrow?
Yes, I'm going to plan to stay in tonight and tomorrow. Temperatures are supposed to be dropping really low tonight, and
yes,
the snow is supposed to start.
It is. Good idea. Stay inside and keep your family safe. Carrie, thank you so much for joining us. And coming up, we're going to talk more to people impacted by Octavia. Dave?
Thanks, Bonnie. As we just saw on radar there in Nashville, Tennessee, the sleet is just ending. But now here we're at the front edge of this big shield of wintry precip, and the snow has just begun at a very popular summer resort, Ocean City, Maryland. There's 17 with snow. Georgetown, Maryland now just starting to snow. It'll start in Dover here in about an hour or so, and then in Philadelphia once you get home from work. And you better get home from work early enough because temperatures are in the teens, as you can see here. And this is just going to be snow on the road. Any traffic will just pack that down, and it'll almost seem as if it's ice out there. Further south and west, we've got the winter storm warning in effect for Richmond, Virginia. Norfolk's going to get some snow and sleet here tonight. I've got the wrong clicker. Alex, can you advance my graphics for me? Thank you. There we go. So here we go. There's the leading edge right now, and there's more on the way. Nashville at the back edge. Here in Kentucky and West Virginia, that snow is coming down, my friend, and it's coming down hard. Visibility is poor. That's going to continue all night long, at least right along the East Coast to 995 from Virginia northward, 85 also, 66 west of Washington, D.C. Tomorrow morning, I think there might be some delays just getting into work here in Washington after the holiday. It's rain and ice here in North Carolina ending by morning. Some snow left over in the mountains, and then what's left of this snowstorm inches toward New York City in the morning, Hartford, New Haven, and Boston, but we're only expecting about 1 to 3 inches of snow there. The heaviest amounts will be south of the Mason-Dixon line this time. Richmond, you could pick up 8 to 12 inches. Over toward Annapolis and Salisbury, Maryland, 8 to 12 inches of snow. There's your timing, the leading edge of our snow here right now. Harrisburg this evening, Philadelphia pretty much till about all night long, 2 to 4 inches there, 1 to 3 up toward New York City, New Haven, Hartford a dusting. Boston does not get slammed this time. That's good news. It looks as if this low is going to behave and head right out to sea. And then we're just left with the super cold air. Did you hear how cold it was this morning in Watertown, New York? 36 below. Paducah, Kentucky with 11 inches of snow today. Third all-time snowfall ever for Paducah, Kentucky, hometown of Sam Champion. Alex, back to you.
And a long day of sleet and snow isn't quite over for Tennessee. What's still coming ahead for the Volunteer State? We'll tell you. And is there a warm-up coming to melt all of this away? That is next.
At last.
Sometimes at last doesn't happen at first.
My love. just come along. My lonely days.
Your dad just kissed my mom.
Are over.
Turning two worlds into one takes love.
And life is like a song.
Helping protect that world takes State Farm.
At Intel, they have technology that lets your face be your password. Oh, that is one secure password.
Intel, this is where it all changes.
We build weather inventions.
Wow, anybody else surprised that actually works?
Mother Nature can absolutely change people.
I'm ready to get out of here and create a new track.
This is a tornado emergency.
Oh my God. It was hard to believe weather could do that.
Never seen anything like this in my life.
Currently in our area, 70 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Tonight, some clouds, low 63, winds south at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Tuesday, a few passing clouds, otherwise generally sunny, high 86, winds southwest at 15 to 25 miles per hour. Tuesday night, showers later at night, thunder possible, low 64, chance of rain 50%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Doers. They don't worry if something's possible. They just do it. At Sears Optical, we're committed to bringing them eyewear that works as hard as they do. Right now, buy one pair and get another free. Quality eyewear for doers. Sears Optical.
How long does it take to grow old? And why does it seem like no one wants to do it? Isn't growing old the same thing as living longer? Living longer is something that's on the mind of every pet parent. And what we feed them matters. At Petco, pets are our sole focus. We handpick a unique selection of food to meet our high standards. Because when we feed them better, our companions thrive. Petco.
What are you doing? There's no dip in that bowl.
They're Pringles tortillas. They're so good they don't need dip.
Why do you have to imaginary dip?
Well, everybody was dipping and I wasn't invited to dip.
Can I have some from your bowl?
Please, have some dip.
All right.
Have some together.
Okay.
Not bad, right?
I think I'll have some more.
It's a double dip. You double dipped. Okay, now I'm going to have to wash this entire...
Pringles tortillas. So good, you don't dip them. You air dip them.
Pringles!
Sweet mother of softness. Charmin.
Take a closer look at Charmin Ultra Soft and you'll love what you see. Not only can you use less, but you can actually see the softness in our comfort cushions.
We all go. Why not enjoy the go with Charmin Ultra Soft?
When you're hungry for the craveable taste of tender fish and shrimp, nothing's better than Long John Silver's. Now, for a limited time, enjoy our new crispy golden fish and shrimp basket for just $3.99 at Long John Silver's.
How do I get hotel deals nobody else gets? I know a guy.
Priceline Negotiator.
I know this guy, Coloito.
And this guy, who knows a guy?
Hey, guy.
I know a guy in New York, Vegas, Dallas. I've known some guys for decades, and some, nice to meet you. Let's deal. My competitors may know a guy.
Xfinity sales professionals are always on the go, meeting new people every day. They're helping families get the latest Xfinity products and services, and they're making customers happy. Jumpstart your career with the best sales training in the industry. Great benefits like discounts on your own Xfinity services and the potential for high earnings. Have what it takes? Apply today and see what doors open for you.
Why do people invest? They invest for what's next. A college dream? A new priority? An active retirement? Whatever your goals are, we can help you invest for what's next. Franklin Templeton Investments. Gain from our perspective.
With the wrong wiper blades, you could be on the road to trouble. But with Michelin Stealth Wiper Blades, with Smart Flex technology and Smart Hinge exterior, you can see clear for the road ahead. Michelin Stealth, a better way forward. Get your Michelin wiper blades at Walmart.
Start your benefits.
Call 888-997-1426 now.
This March.
One man's trash.
This is perfect.
Is another man's wood-powered Jeep gasifier.
Brainstormers, premiering Sunday, March 22nd, only on the Weather Channel.
You've heard about icicles, but what about leafsicles? This is what the ice from Winter Storm Octavia created in Knoxville, Tennessee. A viewer shared these pictures with us via Burst. Now, we want to see your pictures and video, too. Just text the word Octavia, Octavia, to 99,000. And remember, turn your smartphone horizontally so it'll fit the TV screen perfectly. Well, now we're getting reports of ice on leaves and other things in suburban Atlanta. Let's head into the lab with Carl Parker and Alex.
That's right, Carl. You know, we are watching parts of, say, North South Carolina, even a bit of Georgia and Tennessee, seeing some of that iciness. And so there are concerns for the folks who live in Atlanta. They're going, hey, this isn't going to happen again, is it?
Well, you know, it's really, really close. And I think we're probably going to be okay. It looks like this tide of the cold air coming down through South Carolina and into Northeast Georgia has slowed a little bit. And we've also got a lot of rain coming in from the south and from the west. And there's warmer air aloft with that. And when it's heavier rain, it brings some of that warmth down. So I think it may be able to stem this a little bit. And we'll take a look at the radar in just a moment. But we are really, really concerned about what's going to happen in North Carolina tonight.
Absolutely. You know, places like Raleigh dealt with big problems last year. Some reports that there's already sleet accumulation on the roads around Raleigh. So, you know, they're going, all right, so what does this mean for late drivers or the morning commute?
It's primarily going to be an overnight thing, but a lot of people may run out of power in the middle of the night. And so what we've got is this warmer air that's coming over top of surface freezing air. That's setting the stage for getting rain falling into sub-freezing air. Then notice the white there. As the white moves farther east, it gets closer to North Carolina overnight tonight. That strong mid-level wind, so there's a lot of lift that's coming in right at that time, right as we've got the warmer air moving in. And so this is a depiction of that in the modeling, where the dark blue line is showing us the surface freezing line. So that's the dividing line between rain and freezing rain.
And then this is the dividing line between rain and snow. So to the north you have snow, to the south you have rain. So you're saying you've got rain, but then falling into that pocket of cold air at the surface.
And what's happening with this line is this is the leading edge of the slightly warmer air that's coming in aloft here, where we change over from sub-freezing to freezing at 5,000 feet. And so with that slightly warmer air overhead, we can get the rain, and the rainfall rates really could be significant there in North Carolina right through the overnight and then finally winding down by tomorrow morning. So right now what we're thinking is that there is this potential for a half of an inch, maybe three-quarters of an inch of ice accumulation. That is huge. I don't know if you've ever been in moderate or heavy freezing rain. I was in that one time in Harrisburg.
Yeah.
And I remember I went out to my car and it was literally encased. Like I literally had to chip at my car just to get the door open.
Yeah, dig through it or if you've got a car starter, lucky enough, let it heat up and try to melt it from the inside out. But even that, if it's thick enough, it's tough.
Yeah, it's very tough. And obviously there's a lot of weight in water. And so when you add ice to all these things that are in the air, whether it's branches or power lines, whatever, they start getting weighed down and eventually they snap. And that is really going to be the worry here in central North Carolina and also in parts of northwest South Carolina, right around Greenville, talking about maybe a half of an inch of ice there. So over a pretty large swath, there is potential for power outages in addition to obviously major problems on the roads tomorrow
really
morning.
Right along Interstate 85 from Greenville over to Spartanburg and Gaffney, then right up to Charlotte and further off towards the east. So a big thoroughfare, not just for the people who live here, but for people who might be trying to travel through.
Yeah, and this is one of those spots where we tend to get very bad ice storms.
Yes.
I'm sure you've been through that when you were there. There's the timing of this in Raleigh, the ice coming in tonight and then lingering all night. It's going to be a fairly long duration event, which is why we think there could be a lot of it. And that's what's happening right now. There is the Atlanta Metro, and we'll take another look at this at the top of the hour. And so it's trying to make some progress, but it looks like it's hanging up there. We'll see what happens.
Everyone
we'll
in Atlanta is doing whatever voodoo they can to try to keep it away.
We've
got to get it away. Hey, thanks so much, Carl. Dave, we'll send it back out to you.
Okay, guys, Winter Storm Octavia, huh? Putting more than 70 million on alert from Mississippi to D.C. We'll have more after this.
Currently in our area, 70 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Tonight, some clouds, low 63, winds south at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Tuesday, a few passing clouds, otherwise generally sunny, high 86, winds southwest at 15 to 25 miles per hour. Tuesday night, showers later at night, thunder possible, low 64, chance of rain 50%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Right now, more than 35 million people are under a winter storm warning and in the path of Octavia. It's a storm with double trouble tonight. We have ice coating trees and roads like this video from Middle Tennessee.
Then Octavia's snowy side, breaking records here in Bowling Green, Kentucky. This was the first 8-inch snowstorm there since 1968. That's 47 years ago.
And take a look at the radar. You can see we've got a mixed bag. We've got snow to the north, wintry mix, and freezing rain in the pinks and purples, and then rain further off towards the south. And we are with you tonight to keep you informed and prepared for this storm. Thanks for joining us. I'm Alex Wilson.
And I'm Dave Schwartz. We haven't seen one of these storms in a long time.
No. Ice, one of the biggest problems. And we're seeing some decent accumulations. We've got power outages. Arkansas, over 30,000 power outages at this point.
Now, you can depend on us for Octavia coverage. We have live coverage, of course. But first, let's get you updated on the very latest news headlines coming out of this storm.
73 million people are affected by some form of wintry precipitation tonight, and that includes several major airports. So far, more than 4,000 flights have been delayed. Dozens of schools in Washington, D.C., they're already closed tomorrow. And in Georgia, we have new reports of ice accumulation on trees and on a few roads.
Our nation's capital is bracing for Octavia. The snow has begun in Washington, D.C., and they could end up with 8 inches of snow. And so far for the whole season, 3.8 inches for the whole winter.
Absolutely.
So we could triple that by tomorrow morning.
Folks in the mid-Atlantic have almost been not jealous, but a little like, hey, why is the Northeast getting all the snow? We're not getting anything, Kate. I think a lot of the kids have been waiting for that snow day that some have already received for tomorrow.
Yeah, we're actually already seeing a couple of school closures in Virginia. So we're going to wait and see what happens here in the district, see if they cancel schools or governments. We haven't quite heard about all that yet. But here's the deal. It just started snowing about 3 o'clock in the afternoon here. It's accumulated pretty quickly. You know, the places where you're not seeing snow here behind me, this is where they had some salt earlier out on the roads, so, or on the sidewalks and the roads. But if you look way off here in the distance, I know it's kind of getting dark here, but we do not have clear roads. The snow has accumulated on them, and here's the problem with that. If you put down some of the salt on top of this now to try and melt some of that ice, melt some of that snow, it's not going to work. It's too cold. Here's the science behind this. Okay, so you've got the snow, and it's pretty light and fluffy right now because it is so cold outside. But if you already have a layer of this on the roads and you try and put some salt on top of it, once you get down to about 15 or 20 degrees, it's not going to melt it. So what they're doing here in the district is the Virginia Department of Transportation has also said this. They're actually putting sand down as well on top of the roads to help with some traction. Obviously, we still got some cars out and about. We still have some folks out and about, you know, out here on the roads. We're at Union Station. We've got the Capitol right over here. We haven't heard word yet on whether that will be open tomorrow, but you know what was beneficial? That when the snow started, you know, everything was closed. It was President's Day here in the nation's capital. So if there's a silver lining to this is that we already didn't have a lot of people on the road. The bad news is that tomorrow morning when you wake up, you're going to have inches upon inches of snow, and you're going to be waking